Okay, back again. It's Doug Adima, and just running through some of the functionality and how to administer a WordPress site, and just using a demo site. So this is part three, and the last part, in which I'm going to talk about calendars a bit, just talk about some of the backups that are happening, support other training user IDs, and just a quick summary. So this should be a pretty quick video. But that'll kind of wrap up most of the main topics. So I'm going to move across to the browser and bring up the website again. And we ended up before on sermons here. And let me just get things lined up again. So let's talk about calendars then. And calendars are what we would show to show kind of what's going on in the chapel or church, and just some of the recurring kind of events that are happening within the church, and some of the special events as well. And there's really two types of calendars that you can have. One of them, and the one I'm going to show you here, is completely kind of contained within WordPress. So I'm using a plugin called My Calendar. And that plugin allows you to put recurring events, and allows you to display events in a monthly format like this, and then also put it in a list type format. So a very handy little plugin, totally self-contained within WordPress. Now, a lot of chapels, and Southdale Bible Chapel is one of them as well, we use a Google Calendar, and I've linked across our calendar. Let me see where I have that. So I think the calendar just disappeared here. I gotta find it somewhere, but anyway, we'll just leave that for now. And the calendar itself, so it could be a Gmail, Google Calendar that I could link across to. Depends on how you want to maintain it. The benefit of using a Google Calendar as opposed to using WordPress Calendar is if you have somebody that's not really that familiar with WordPress but understands Google Calendar, that they can maintain kind of the events out there and not have to get into WordPress all the time. So big advantage there. If you're comfortable with WordPress and you don't want to set up a lot of events, probably just within WordPress is fine. So I'm going to show you just the My Calendar plugin. It's all totally contained within WordPress. Now that I've totally confused you, so here is My Calendar. So there's a submenu here on the left-hand side called My Calendar, and I'm going to show you how to manage events. And I've, for this particular demo site, I have three events that have been loaded up into the calendar. One of them is the communion service on a recurring basis, then the family Bible hour, and then a prayer and Bible study. So pretty typical of most assemblies. So you can see there's the prayer and Bible study one, family Bible hour, and communion service. And these are all recurring weekly events set up to keep going for 999 times. So that's a lot of years. And just gonna wait for that to come up here. So you can see the communion service here. You could put some information about the communion service, and that would show on the calendar as well if somebody clicked on it. You can see when it started, it was July the 30th, and it runs through from 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. It's a recurring event that's repeating 999 times every 1 week, and that's the event itself. So you could, I'm not going to save the event here, but I could update it here. I could call it the Lord's Supper instead of communion service, and that would also update, and you could save that. So that's the calendar of events. Let me just wait for this to come up. And here you can see the three events. If I wanted to add a new event, even a one-time event, I just click on here, click Add New, put a title into it, put the start or the date and the start and end time, and then save it, and then it would start to appear on our calendar. So lots of other things you could do here if you had multiple locations. I don't usually use locations for churches. You could categorize them, you could set up groups, you can have different styles, but just best to kind of leave most of those things alone and just work around managing events and adding new events in there. All right, so let's talk a little bit about backups. So for sites, when you go live, you want to make sure that your work is backed up. Now, often the backups don't have to be overly frequent, probably once every week or so. I set these all up in advance, and then I take daily backups often, and or weekly backups. Sometimes you'll see weekly backup. In this case, I've just got the one because it's a demo site. And but a daily backup, it does a database backup, backs up the plugins, and I've got another one that I usually do, which is a file backup as well, but this is a demo site. So just know, I guess, overall, when the site is set up, I want to make sure backups are running in case of some catastrophic error and we have to recover. So, and I like to take those files and offload them, and I put them onto an FTP server, if that term is familiar to you. An FTP server on my within my environment here, so that I can restore it at any point if I need to restore it, both the platform itself and the content itself. Okay, so those are backups. I think I'll just show you how to customize the appearance of the site too. So let me bring that up. Okay, the customization page. This, for many of the chapels that I built sites for, I use a theme called the Ample theme. And the Ample theme, there's thousands and thousands of themes out there. I like this theme because it's pretty flexible and it's free, so the price is right. And this allows me to kind of customize the headers, the backgrounds, the color schemes, the fonts and stuff that are used on it, and customize this particular home page. So you should not have to get into this to do much. This is more development, but I wanted to make sure that you were aware that that's there. In this case, the Ample theme, this home page is all customized through this particular area, so the customization area. I also use a theme, another free theme called Tesseract, and Tesseract is got a lot more power. I use it for more complex sites, and there's little information here, and there's actually more in the pages themselves that are buried within WordPress. So kind of enough there. These are pretty self-explanatory that are here, again, allowing you to customize the look and feel of the site, the fonts of the site, the navigation of the site. But it's not something that you should have to go and be concerned about. But I want to make sure that you are aware of the themes, and that a lot of the customization of look and feel is through this. Okay, so for support, a big thing to keep doing, and this is something that I handle for most of the sites, unless it's something that you want to handle for yourself. And but I haven't had anybody say that. I think they prefer not to have to worry about releases of WordPress and plugins and stuff. So I have updated this site already, so it's got all the latest plugins, themes, and the latest version of WordPress. So here you can see I could update from this particular part of the dashboard, and that's usually what I do when I go through the sites and just make sure that they're up to date. So I'll cover that myself. So if you go into the site and say everything's out of date, I'll be back shortly probably to update it. And again, usually I do that on every couple of weeks or once a month. When a new WordPress install comes out, which is usually once every 6 or 8 weeks, then I'll usually go into the site for sure, update WordPress, and made sure that it's all up to date for it. So the next thing I'm just going to show you is on websteward.ca, and if I click that, that's my home page, and I'm going to try to store some of these training videos or links to the training videos there. If you click on this training thing here, the training that I'm recording here is mostly very specific to churches and to the sites that I've built. So, but there's lots of material out. If you go out on YouTube and type in WordPress, you're going to get so many hits on potential training videos. So I've selected just a few of them out here. If you're just administering the site, and especially if you have sermons, I would watch this video. I would watch the tutorial for administrators. Stay away from this developer videos, and maybe this one here. So mostly this one, and this one. And that's going to give you a little bit of more information. And I didn't really go into a lot of detail on how to update pages and posts and stuff like that, because that information is out there. It's available. It's the same, or much the same for all WordPress sites. So just kind of wrapping up, then I just want to show you users. So you can see users are administered through the WordPress admin panel too. So click on that. And for this site, I've got the Web Steward account, and I've got that set up for all sites that I've written so that I can get into the site and maintain it and keep the plugins and platform updated. And then you can see here I've set up a admin. So for your site, you'll have an administrative ID. You must have it because you're hopefully into the site as well. So that's user IDs. If you wanted to add other users, you could do that. Usually there's maybe one or two administrators in the site. You don't want everybody in there. So this should be good enough, typically, to get you started. You could share the administrative password with other people if they need to get into the site. So that's the setup for the particular WordPress site that you have. Again, this is very generic training. So if your site may look a little bit different than this, but a lot of the stuff that I went through on WordPress, that's all going to be the same. So even though your site may look a little bit different than this, a lot of the components are going to be the same, and hopefully you've been able to derive something from it as well. So encourage you to get out on the site, really, you know, start to familiarize yourself with how to maintain it. Do it on a fairly frequent basis so that you don't lose the information. These videos that I've pulled together, I'm going to post in this websteward.ca/training area, and then you can refer to it a little bit later on if you need a refresher. So anyway, I think that's all I wanted to cover, and hope that these videos have been helpful. Thanks for your patience as I've stumbled through them.